me throw this stick out yonder. You pick it up and fetch it back. Okay?
Well, we'll do it again.
Go on, boy. Get it. Fetch it, too. Fetch it, fetch it. All right, I'll show you. Just once more now. You watch. Catch on, Duke? Catch on, boy. Do it once more. Catch it, too. Get it. Come on. Get it. Shucks.
You know something, Uncle Jed? That there is a real dumb dog.
Well, I don't think he's so dumb, Jethro. He just learned you how to fetch sticks for him.
But the dog is the one that's supposed to do the fetching. Why, there's a fella down the street that has a dog that fetches sticks for him all day.
Well, next time you want some sticks fetched, go down the street and let that dog fetch them. You just don't care nothing about it.
Ed, do you want some victuals today?
I do, Granny.
I've worked up a right smart appetite fetching sticks for old Duke.
Yes, that's the trouble around here. The critters are taking over. Tilly May has done made pets out of everything but my pickled turnips. What are we going to do for victuals?
Hey, I remember something Mr. Drysdale told us when we first moved in here.
What's that?
He said any time Granny didn't feel like cooking, there were some folks that had fetched food over to us.
Here in Beverly Hills?
Yes, ma'am. All you got to do is call them on the telephone and tell them what you want.
Nellies. That's mighty neighborly. Your caller name, Jethro?
Let's see. Cater.
We call her first name?
It's a woman. Beverly.
Beverly Caterer?
Must be a widow woman.
She's the best cook, Dad. They have more time.
Well, let's call up the widow and see what she's got cooking today.
Now, just a minute, Dad. I want it made clear that I'm going to do something for her in return.
Oh, naturally. We don't take charity.
Come on, Duke. Let's try it again.
Oh, howdy, Miss Operator. This here is Jed Clampett. Well, I'm wanting to call a widow caterer. Beverly's a Christian name. I don't rightly know what her late husband was called. Anyway, she's the one that cooks the food and takes it around to folks. Yes, ma'am, that's it. Beverly Caterer. Oh, caterers, is it? More than one. Looks like the widow's got some young'uns to help her.
That's good, Jed. Most times they leave home. Just when you...
Well, thank you, ma'am. What was that you saying, Granny?
I was saying that most times the young'uns leave home. Just about the time that you're...
Well, howdy to you, Miss Beverly Caterer. This here is Jed Clampett. Sounds like a right friendly woman.
Howdy, Beverly. This here's Granny. I'm a widow myself. And I was just saying to Jed, it's nice when the young'uns stay home to help you. So many times they leave, just when you need them most.
I'll let you women folks talk about the vittles, but first I just want to say, if you ever need a fence mended or a well dug or any heavy work at all, you just call on Jethro and me. Now, here's Granny.
Beverly? What you got on the back of the stove this morning? I don't want to put you to no extra trouble. Huh? Well, me, I'm partial to baked possum. But we'll take jowls or fatback or sow belly. Any kind of meat will pleasure us considerably. What's that? Bunch of nuts. Well, you can send them along. I'll tell you right now, the critters will get the bulk of them. Now tell me something we can do for you, honey. Do what? Hello? I declare, Jed, I never knowed anybody could turn nasty quicker than her.
What do I set her off?
Hard to tell, Jed. A generous woman like her probably gets took advantage of a lot. And tired to boot, I reckon.
Uncle Jed, I can't learn this dumb old dog to fetch his stick.
Well, Duke ain't about to waste your time chasing a piece of wood. He's a hunting dog.
Well, can I take him hunting then? I'd like to see him chase something.
Praise be. That's an idea that might put some fresh meat on our table.
All right, boy. It makes more sense than fetching a stick, especially to Duke.
You want to come along, Granny?
No. I better stay here and guard my kitchen.
Okay. Come on, Duke. Let's get the guns.
Guard your kitchen against who, Granny?
Against Ellie's critters, that's who. They's beginning to take over. Why, I can't hardly... That little rascal learned to open the icebox. Bim's the last of my pickled pawpaws. Come back here, you hairy little varmint. Get your pawpaw picking paws off of my pickled pawpaws.
Well, hi, Miss Beverly. It's me, Jed Clampett. Sounds like you're in the right friendly mood again. Jethro's going out to shoot us some fresh game meat, and the monkey got in the icebox, and Granny's right upset. Now, Beverly, could you spare us a jar of pickled pawpaws? What's that? Why, Miss Cater, I never... Hello, Miss Cater?
Hey, Uncle Jed, see that Miss Cater being a widow, such a good cook and friendly and generous and all? How about you courting her? Get Ellie a new ma, huh?
I don't think so, Jethro. She's got a temper, goes off just like that. And when it does, she turns plumb nasty. Matter of fact, I'm beginning to wonder whether Mr. Cater passed on natural or not.
Just an idea. Come on, dude.
How come you're toting so many guns in that shovel, Jethro?
Granny gave me strict orders not to come back empty-handed. I'm ready for anything that jumps, flies, runs, or digs into the ground.
Good luck, boy.
Oh, gee, thank goodness you're back. I didn't want to disturb you at the meeting, but your wife has been calling frantically.
Oh, that woman gets hysterical over nothing. What's it now?
Well, it seems there's a kangaroo in your backyard.
You see, the slightest little...
What?
What? A kangaroo? Where did it come from?
Australia. That's the only continent where...
Oh, I know that. How did it get in my backyard?
Well, your wife is rather incoherent, but Ravenswood said it's from the Second National Bank of Melbourne.
Second National Bank. Oh, that's where Gene Sandbloom was transferred to from. That explains his Christmas card.
May I share the humor of the situation, Chief?
Well, I sent him an alligator wallet, so he said he was going to send me a kangaroo pouch.
Kangaroo pouch? On the hoof, as it were. Mr. Sandbloom does have a sense of humor.
Yes, we'll have the zoo pick it up. I'll call Margaret.
Mr. Drysdale's office. Oh, Ravenswood. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Good, I'll tell Mr. Drysdale. Oh, and don't worry about the kangaroo. The zoo will take care of it. Right. Cheerio. Ravenswood has your wife under sedation, and she's resting comfortably.
Oh, good.
There we are. A bit of mutton and Yorkshire pudding should hit the spot. You may be from down under, but we're all part of the empire. Oh, drat. The zoo must have already come for you.
Oh, I'm gonna cook up a rabbit stew. Soon as Jethro shoots me one or two, then we'll all sit down to the table and we'll eat, then we'll eat. Jethro leave to go hunting yet?
Yep.
Well, he needn't have bothered. There's a jackrabbit out that high. A drop. And there is a giant jackrabbit out in our backyard, and it is this high.
Granny, you and me have seen some good-sized jacks in our day, but not 5 foot tall.
Kid, there's a lot of things we never seen back home that we are seeing out here. And that's one of them. A piano playing, icebox opener, pawpaw pilfered ape.
All right, Granny. I'll go take a look at your jackrabbit.
Come on, you can see for yourself. He can jump over this house, I tell you, in one hop.
Whereabouts is he?
I don't know. But sure as I live and breathe, he was sitting right there, 5 foot tall and looking me in the eye.
5 foot tall sitting, was he?
Yes, he was. Where did that jackrabbit go?
Why don't you look out front? Maybe he hopped over the house, just like you said.
You think I'm talking nonsense, but you'll see, because I'll find him.
What's all shout about, Granny?
Nothing. Don't tell her, Jed. I don't want her making a pet out of all that meat. Let me go in the kitchen and get out my biggest pot and start peeling taters. Lots of them. Here, Jack.
Who's Jack, Paul?
Never mind, Ellie. Just try to keep your critters from pestering Granny. You got her so upset, she's got into her jug, and now she's seeing visions.
What kind of visions?
Well, I reckon it's all right to tell you. Granny thinks she seed a 5-foot jackrabbit.
Howdy, Mr. Jackrabbit. The weather's turned off real nice, ain't it? There's some mighty fine clover out there on the lawn if you want to fatten up. I mean, if you're hungry. Don't you go away. There's somebody I want you to meet. I'll be right back. Jed, come on, running. I found him. Come quick. Jed, I seen him again. The giant jackrabbit.
I bet you did.
He's right out front. Come on, I'll show him to you.
Maybe you better lay down a spell.
No, he'll get away again.
All right, I'll take a look.
See him, Jed? I lost my glasses. But he must be out there somewhere.
Well, yeah, I see him.
Is he out on the lawn eating clover?
Great big old pink jackrabbit.
Pink!
Now, don't get upset. There's other colors, too. There's a blue one, there's a green one. Here comes one with purple polka dots.
Oh, I wish I could see him.
What's that you say, Mr. Jackrabbit? All right, I'll tell her. He says he thinks you ought to go in and lay down.
Yeah, I think I better head, Jed.
Howdy, Miss Jane.
Jethro, and you've got a wonderful surprise. But why do you look so worried, noble beast?
Because I can't find no good hunting place, that's why. And Granny gave the strict orders to bring home some meat.
Oh, Jethro, food should never be a problem to people of your means. There are markets, supermarkets, caterers.
Uncle Jed called that their Beverly Cater. He got mean mouth something awful.
Mean mouth?
He says she's the nastiest tempered woman that ever answered a telephone.
Well, Mr. Drysdale shall hear this. The bank has a substantial interest in Beverly Caterers. You wait here.
Well, howdy, Beverly. This is Jed Clampett. You're sounding right pleasant again. Now, wait, ma'am. I ain't called to ask for victuals. It's just that Granny's laying down with a right smart headache. And I was wondering whether you could fix her a poultice. Tell her to do what? Well, I don't hardly see how that could help a headache. Now, wait a minute, man. Don't go flying off the handle. I just... Hello? Hello? No two ways about it. That woman has got a temper like a wet hornet.
Hello, Beverly Caterers. One moment, please.
Hello. Have you spoken to a Mr. Jed Clampett today? What? Now, just a minute, young lady. What is your name? What do you mean, put and tame? Now, you put Mr. Tinsman on the phone and tell him it's Milburn Drysdale calling. What? The nastiest tempered young woman I ever spoke to.
Who's that, Granny?
The giant jackrabbit.
Oh, him again. All right, where's the jug?
What jug?
The jug that rabbit keeps coming out of. The jug gives you that headache.
I ain't touched the jug. I busted my head running into them curtains.
Yeah, sure. They'll do it all right.
I gotta catch that giant jackrabbit. Where's my shotgun?
Well, Jethro's got it out hunting.
Well, then we gotta catch a snare and put a snare out for him.
Granny, wouldn't you rather lay back down and let me bring you a nice big cup of black coffee?
Now, I'm gonna catch that big giant jackrabbit whether you help me or not, and I don't care.
I'll help you.
All right. Now, you get me a nice big stout rope and put some bait in there.
Yeah, it'd take about 2 dozen carrots for a rabbit that size.
Now you're thinking straight.
Yeah. Just took me a while.
Jethro.
The rest detention is about to be made.
Yes. Now, I'll give your Uncle Jed a message for
Tell
me.
Him that the young woman who was so rude on the telephone will arrive in person to offer her abject apologies.
Yes. And tell Granny she needn't worry about food.
The young lady will also bring with her a truck full of delicious piping hot viands and an assortment of tasty beverages, all of which will be offered at your pleasure.
Yes. Have I anything else to say, Miss Hathaway?
No, Chief, I think you've said it all.
That sure is going to make Uncle Jed and Granny happy. Thank you, Mr. Drysdale.
Not at all. Glad to do it.
Jethro, don't you think you should reward me for my efforts?
Well, all I got with me is a nickel and two pennies, but you can have that.
There are other ways for a handsome young man to reward a young lady.
There is?
Yes. Tell me, do you enjoy kissing?
Well, I like to kiss girls.
Well, then, I'm going to close my eyes and I want you to enjoy yourself. Go ahead, Jethro. Enjoy yourself.
I am.
Get out of here, you shameless vixen!
Yes, ma'am. Come on, dude. I'd like you for a kiss.
Now, let's see. If I were to tie another rope onto the bottom of that limb, pull it down, and then take my loop and put some carrots in it. Howdy, Mr. Jackrabbit. Would you like to step into my kitchen? You ain't gonna get away from me again, I can tell you that. Now, are you gonna come peaceable, or do I have to take you by force?
Down, Granny. What's the matter now?
The giant jackrabbit. I had him cornered, but he fist fought me.
Fist fought you?
Yes, he did. Now you go outside and belt him upside the jaw.
Granny, where are you hiding them jugs?
Do no cooking. Like I said, that there Beverly caterer is going to bring over a whole truckload of viands and beverages.
I ain't depending on nobody with a temper as bad as her. Besides, I don't need her viands. For the next couple of weeks, we're going to be eating high on the rabbit.
Well, where'd you get all the rabbits?
One rabbit, Jethro.
One rabbit? He must be a whopper.
Remember those big mountain jacks we used to see back home?
Yeah.
I seen me a jackrabbit that could put a pair of them in his pocket.
In his pocket?
Sure. He stands 5 feet tall and he has a pocket, right? You don't believe me, do you?
Oh, yes, I do, Granny.
No, you don't.
Oh, Granny, I sure I do.
No, you don't.
All right, I don't believe you.
How dare you call me a liar?
Mr. Tinsman, do I have to face Mr. Clampett all by myself?
Yes, you do. You're the one who insulted him on the phone. And you're the one he'll expect an apology from.
But he talked like a nut.
Miss Billington, a man as rich as Mr. Clampett may talk like an eccentric, but never like a nut.
I sure hope he'll forgive me.
He'll forgive you. If he's anywhere between 15 and 95, he'll forgive you. I'll take the food round to the kitchen.
Is Mr. Clampett at home?
I'm Jed Clampett. Come right in.
This little fella don't say much, but he's right smart.
Mr. Clampett, I'm here to apologize about the way I spoke to you on the telephone earlier today.
Oh, you're Beverly Caters.
Yes, sir.
Well, you're a deal younger than I figured. He prettier, too.
Thank you. I'm awfully sorry about losing my temper when you called.
Oh, now, I understand. Woman works hard all day cooking and doing for others. Youngin's hanging on her apron, she gets a mite waspish. And you not having a husband to help.
Yes, that's right. I don't have a husband.
How many youngins you got?
Youngins?
Helping you with the cooking and fetching over to your place.
Oh, help. Well, let's see. Seven.
Seven? Well, you must be from our part of the country. Got started young, didn't you? Well, come on. Granny will be wanting to meet you. She's out in the kitchen.
Oh, that's Mr. Tinsman at the back door. He's my boss.
Come in. I'm Jed Clampett.
A real pleasure, Mr. Clampett. I'm Bill Tinsman. I hope everything has been straightened out and the Beverly Caterers will always be welcome in your home.
Why, you bet you're lying. There's a mighty fine young woman. She says you're her boss.
That is right. I own Beverly Caterers.
What dickens you say? Can you do that out here?
Why, of course. Mr. Drysdale holds a small mortgage, but as soon as that's paid off, she's all mine.
Now that don't take the ham off the hog.
Yes, yes. Now, Jed, you can see I ain't been at no junk.
These folks is Beverly Caterers and Bill Tinsman. He's the one that does all the cooking.
I hope we can cook for you, Granny.
You can commence with this one. I caught him, now you can cook him. Why, you little varmint, you untied my giant jackrabbit.
Giant jackrabbit?
Yes, my giant jackrabbit. That's what I wanted you to cook for me. He stands about 5 foot tall, has brown eyes, and a pocket right here. Now, don't you go away. I'll go get him for you.
Granny, we'll be back directly. You all go in the parlor and let the little fella play piano for you.
You say eccentric? I still say nuts.
I say you're right. Let's get out of here.
I can't understand it. He was free. Why should he return?
Something must have frightened him.
I'll say, if he prefers his crate to freedom.
Yes, but what could it have been?
Hello, over there.
Yes, Granny, what is it?
You see anything of a jackrabbit?
No, we haven't.
You won't find any jackrabbits in Beverly Hills, Granny.
I'll telephone the zoo, sir.
I say there's a giant jackrabbit around here someplace, and I'm going to find him if it's the last thing I ever do.
Sure you are, Granny. Now, come in and lay down. I'm going to get that nice Beverly Caterers to make a poultice for your head.
Granny, you caught something in your snyder.
See, Jed wanted to tell you.
What'd she catch, Ellie?
Jethro.
Hey, Uncle Jed, cut me down. Uncle Jed, he cut me down.